Good morning, children. Glad to meet you again today. Before we start our activities, let us start the day with a meditation with God's Word this morning, taken from Journey to God's Promised Land book, written by Pastor Maralap Sagala. Our topic for today is No One Can See God's Face. Before we proceed, shall we start with a prayer? Thank you, Lord, for the new day. Now we are ready to listen to your words. May your Holy Spirit be within us. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Our memory verse for today is from Exodus chapter 33, verse 20. It says, He said, You cannot see my face, for no one may see me and live. When Moses wanted to make sure to know God better, namely God who led them on their way out of Egypt to the Mount of Sinai, Moses asked God to be pleased to show his glory to Moses by saying, May you show me your glory. God was pleased that Moses could see and know him better. But God is a God in spirit who cannot be seen by human eyes. However, because of how much God is pleased by Moses, God was pleased to enable Moses to see God by seeing God in His glory. Then the Lord said, There is a place near me where you may stand on a rock. When my glory passes by, I will put you in a cleft in the rock and cover you with my hand until I have passed by. Then I will remove my hand and you will see my back, but my face must not be seen. Moses was given the opportunity to see the glory of God and only the back of God Himself. Moses could not see the face of God because God said, You cannot see my face, for no one may see me and live. Sin limits our ability to see God's face. But one moment in the kingdom of heaven, we will meet God face to face. Children, let us live holy and remain faithful so that we can meet God face to face in the kingdom of heaven that God has provided for us. This is the end of our morning worship. May God bless us today. Amen.